Welcome to my Canon Rock lesson number 6. In this lesson we're going to be learning two parts of a song, and the song is going to be right after in the melody. The melody, you know, that was the last lesson. We learned the melody, and then after that you have the rock part for a small amount of time. Then you do some different fast things and sweeping and different stuff like that, stuff that I will attempt to show you, and then go on to the next section on that. So anyway, pretty much go all the way up to until you get to the slow part. The slow part will be in less than 7. Okay, so your goal is today is to surpass that stinky play in there. I had to slow that down a lot to be able to play it at least as good as I did, and that wasn't that good, especially the sweet part. But at least I attempted. Maybe you can give a thumbs up for attempting this sweep, because I'm trying to learn sweeping and it's starting to break through. But I just don't have the sync quite yet, but I almost have it. But anyway, if you're really good at sweeping, then dude, this is no problem for you then. That's a small sweep. The hard part also is a bunch of the alternate picking. Now, just to give you a rundown, this is right after you do the melody section. And after you're finishing the melody section, the Canon Rock is going like that. And what normally people do is jump in here somewhere and go, or whichever. It just depends. Sometimes I jump in whenever someone's done that or whatever, and then but the point is just jump in there somewhere and cut off somewhere if you like, instead of that way you can go up here and do this section. So that's what I'm going to show you now. The lesson has begun, officially begun, okay? I had to give you all that to show you where we are and show you all this stuff. Okay, so the pattern, first you're starting on the D string. And that's the 14th, 16th, and 17th fret. These are going to be all triplets here, and this is going to be like really fast. And this was played on the 14th, 16th, and 18th fret. Fingers I'm using to play that is first finger, and then your ring finger, your pinky finger, and then also first finger again, index finger, whatever you want to call it, middle finger, and then pinky. That's what I'm doing. And you do that again. So you can do whichever one you want. If you want to land on with your ring finger or your pinky finger, that's your choice. You're gonna bend up and let go. Try to mute the strings up above it so it doesn't give you that feedback, you know. So close to real speed, and I can't do it real speed, but close to it, it would almost sound like this. Like that, okay? After you do your bend, you go That first bend, you're up here on the 17th fret, which I'm sure you saw that already. The B string. There's the 15th fret, and then bend up there on the 15th fret again, positioning your fingers like this. There's the 14th fret. Then move to the G string, 14th fret. That was the D string, 12th fret, two times. Then bend up on the 14th fret on the G string. And you're holding it, and then you just let go. So that thing's already sounding out by this time. So you're just going to release it. Or you can pick it one more time before you release it, which would be a pre-bend. That's 12, 14, G string. That was the B string, 15th fret, with the pinky finger, that's what I do. And then index finger, 11th fret, G string. And here is the 16th note, I think it is. Really fast notes. I can't even begin to try to play it. Fun 2 comes very close. I mean, you listen really close, it's just a hair sloppy, just a hair. But I mean, boy, I tell you what, he is awesome with that. And sadly though, Jerry C is not as good as he should be since he arranged this. But anyway, I think if he can't play it all that good, you know, all the crazy stuff he does up there, all the stuff, there's the debate, but I think he should have made it easier, especially for us, who's having a hard time with it. So, I'll show you the real way, or at least the way I've seen it written, and if not, if he doesn't do it this way, this is how Tron Vol does it at guitarmasterclass.net, where I take guitar lessons. And he actually gives this as a free lesson, and I have those list of links under there, and I've told other people, if you need tabs, go to his lesson, because it's free. Anyway, it's a free lesson. Anybody can go there. You don't have to be a member to view that lesson. I learned this from him, so a lot of this is his stuff, okay? I just changed it just a little bit in some places. In some places, I don't at all. Okay, but I always give credit to him. This is his stuff, mostly. That is the G string, 12th fret, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, you're just kind of rock on, you know, kind of bar that way, but just make sure you kind of lift off of that, so it doesn't sound the G string, because you want to be just playing the B string. See how I'm kind of rocking? One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. It's all one, two, three, four. That's 16 notes. See? That's the 14th and the 15th fret. And then. These last five notes are actually faster, but I'll show you that in here in a second. So, your pattern is, you're not using your ring finger. I'll just make it easier that way to show you, okay? 14, 15, 17. So you're walking up, and then walk back down. And then, these notes was on the G string, the 16th and 14th fret, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, those last five notes are faster, okay, that's what it'll be like. If I could ever play it really fast, you know, you'd know what I mean, but Tron Vol can, so. So you're just bending on that last note, and it might be easier to play with your ring finger. Don't even let your pinky do anything, but that'd mean you have to bend. It seems a whole lot easier to do that, you know, with your pinky finger, let your pinky finger do that, but apparently for some people it's easier to move that fast, because you have to really be moving your fingers, and you also have to be doing this stuff really fast too without tensing up, all that stuff. So anyway, that's the deal. So let me play that through one more time from the beginning. Okay, whenever I'm bending up, and I just tap. Make sure it's all the way up, though. That's on the 20th fret. And after that, I just pull off and, you know, release the bend at the same time. See, that's 15. And then bend up and release that. Hit in the 14th fret after that. That's the high E string hitting the 14th and the 17th fret. And then Tron Vol actually does this. But I like to do a bunch of bending, so it's your choice. But I'll just show you the other way, just so you can, and just in case you don't want to do bending. Because, you know, if you want to add bending, you know what to do. That's 19, 17, 15, 19, 17, and that is the 21st fret, and then bend up. That stuff right there, okay? And then the crazy sweep. Okay, I'm gonna try to put this in slow motion and show you how I'm doing it here, okay? And try not to get lost here. I'll try not to. Now, of course, with sweeping, you know, you have to just sweep through here, you know, you're not picking the individual notes. What I'm doing, I'm already barring on the 15th fret these two notes, but of course they're not playing at the same time. It's 15th fret, B and E string. So I'm pulling off to this note here on the high E from the 19th fret. Then upstroke, because I'm upstroking like this, to the with the next note on the 15th fret, no, B string. Still doing upstrokes, because remember this is a sweep. This is the 16th fret G string. And those, you're just going back down after that. Then you do the same thing, so it's basically the same thing. See the deal there? And try not to hit those notes. I'm still learning sweeping, so give me some slack if you already know how to sweep. Okay. And then, same thing up here. Except you end on the 21st fret. High E. Okay, now, in case you can't do this crazy part, like me, that's what I do. Shortcut and cheat. I just pick real fast on there, and it sounds good when it's fast. that's 14, 15, and 17. I kind of improvise, and I can't even hardly do this that full speed. So that's my lame attempt. That's how I do it, okay? And when I get to the sweet part, sometimes I just go for it and it's messy, but it's kind of is cool almost in a way. But no, it's not. It's lame. So anyway, you know, if I can't even sweep, you know, right, I just maybe, or I don't know, some random sweep. Sometimes I don't even know. It's just whatever comes to me sometimes when I'm playing, so I just do whatever. But anyway, if you're a beginner and you're trying to learn this, take it slow, okay? I've been playing guitar for 2 years, and I'm still having trouble with this. Because this, especially for beginners, if you just started guitar and the very first song you're trying to learn is Canon Rock, it's unrealistic to think you're going to learn it in, say, a couple of months. Now, some people may be, like, awesome and just catch on somehow, but some people learn it perfectly in 1 year. It depends on who you are. It depends on how much practice you got. So, practice time, all that stuff. Okay? So, good luck with that, okay? Now, we're going to go on to a new section. This is right after what we just played, and right before the next melody, which, when I say we get to the melody, then cool. That's for lesson 5. You can go back to refer to that if you haven't learned that, or you need a refresher. After that would be the slow part, which would be lesson 7. Okay, so this is kind of my personal touch on this part, just a little bit here and there. What you'll be doing is hitting downstroke for the G string and the upstroke for the D string on this section. Just this first part I'll show you, okay? And this is the 7th fret and the 6th fret. And this, that's just, you know, that's the upstroke. I mean, mute it out. 7, 6, 7. That move right there is on the D string. You play one time and you hammer on, or you play it one time on the 4th fret, and then you hammer on 5, 7 and slide up to the 9th. Then you play the 7th fret, D string, then the 10th fret, A string, you go back to the 7th fret after hitting the 10th fret on the A string, you're on the 7th fret now on the D string. That's the 9th fret, D string, and then 6th fret, G string. You slide from the 6th to the 2nd fret. Okay. Alright. Rewind is needed. As always. And every time you hear that, that's going to be open. 3, 2, 3, 2. You don't hit 2 again. Like that. That's where you stop, actually. 3, 2, 3. So between those is the open. That's 7 open. And then you just hit the 10th fret and hold it. So there's different ways of doing this part. What my favorite way is to do is First slide from the 6th fret to the 7th fret on the G string, index finger. And that next note, the 9th fret, is going to be hammered on, okay, with your ring finger. This move, this whole move, you're going to be playing, picking one, twice. That's what I do on the G string and then the B string. On the B string, you're going to be playing the 7th fret and hammer on to the 10th fret. Like that. Don't make that mistake. That's the 12th fret, open, 10, open, 8, open. After you hit the 8, you go back to the 12, do that open, and then hold down the 10th. And here's the first thing that I just added earlier. That's the 7th fret, pinch harmonic, bend up, as though you were hitting the 9th fret. So that's bending up a full step. Okay. After that, you'll want to go up here for some tapping here. And you can do it however fast or, you know, slow you want. Or kind of like that, okay? So the fret numbers for the first section will be 10, 12, 15. There's several ways to do this. You can, you don't even need your pick right now, so you can just put that away if you want. You'll have it whenever you're playing, because, you know, you'll be wanting to get ready for the next part, but it's okay. Doing what I, if you want to do it exactly how I do it, normally I will tap on, first I'll be having the 10th fret already down with the index finger there. I'll tap the 15th fret, let off, hammer on to the 12th fret, pull off. So they're taking turns there. Or you can, you know, do it a reverse. Yeah, however you want to do it. Do some crazy stuff, variations if you want. After that, you'll be going up to the 17th fret, same pattern. So just do some crazy steps, and so just make sure you land on the 17th fret. You might have to break a little bit of rhythm there, just if you want to do whatever, some reckless stuff like I do. Like that. just get right back in rhythm right away or something. After that, well, that's like basically almost to the very end here. Because, I might say the very end. After that, you'll do the same thing that we just did. Do something different there if you want to, or add a pinch harmonic, or just do like you did last time, and then just like last time, and then go. That's 12 on the high E string, 12, 10, and then 9. And then my added part. You can mute that if you want. That'll make it sound better instead of. That's just the G power chord and the A power chord. So you can see my picking hand. You'll probably want that to be more of a dead note. Just however it comes out, you know. After that, then you'll just be playing the melody again. With that is the end of this lesson. Big long lesson, I know, but we crammed two things together, so that way, next lesson, we can focus on the slow part. Here's a sneak peek.